Questions on power system protection related topics as asked in ISRO previous papers. So this particular video will be consisting exclusively ISRO papers only. So let us see this question from ISRO 2014. Which of the following represents the sequence of operation of an isolator, circuit breaker, earth switch while operating a circuit? See, basically first we have to understand, as I was telling, switchgear is a combination of, okay, switchgear is a combination of what? A relay which senses the fault, and this relay will give that sensing signal to a circuit breaker. Basically it gives a signal to a switch. What will the switch do? Switch will do the isolation part. That means it will be isolating the faulty part from the healthy part. So first it is very much essential to know about the different type of switches. So the first type of switch that we will that is there is fuse. So fuse is basically a thermal switch, okay, thermal switch. So I can say the fuse is like a combination of relay and a switch, because fuse is a thermal switch. It is based on thermal effect of electricity. That means fuse is basically an element which will be carrying the normal operating current. Okay, it will carry the normal operating current. Suppose if the current value increases, then I square into R into T, heat energy produced in the fusing element also, that or this fuse also increases, and at one particular point of the temperature, that fuse will melt off and it will cut off the circuit. So that is basically fuse. Okay. And next, another thing that we have to see about different type of switches is that is an isolator. Okay, isolator. Okay, when we are talking about fuse, so this is the fuse, and fusing current, I mean the current at which the fuse will blow off, is directly proportional to its physical dimension, that is diameter to the power of 3/2. Okay, that is the fusing current proportional to. Okay, and regarding fusing current, there is another factor called as fusing factor. Okay, another current called as fusing factor, where fusing factor is equal to, okay, fusing current divided by, okay, fusing current divided by fuse rated current. Fuse rated current. So what is fusing current means? It is the current where the fuse will melt off. And fuse rated current is the maximum value of current that the fuse can carry without melting. Let us say a fuse is rated at 10 amperes. That doesn't mean that it will burn at 10 amperes. No, up to 10 amperes of current it will happily carry without any problem. If the current goes beyond 10, maybe at some 11 amperes is its fusing current. Okay, is a fusing current. At fusing current it will, okay, it will melt. So one important question or one important concept that you have to observe here is fusing factor is always greater than 1 with respect to a fuse. Okay, so good fuses, okay, if a fuse is good, then fuse factor should be near to 1. Okay, it should not be much higher, it should be near to 1. But if the fuse quality is little bad, then fusing factor will be much greater than 1. Okay, so generally normally used fuses in housing, okay, housing by house wiring application, the fusing factor will be around 1.9 to 1.5. But there are some cartridge fuses or high capacity fuses. So such kind of high capacity fuses will have fusing factor around 1.2 to 1.4. Okay, like cartridge fuses. Okay, this kind of fuses. Whereas normal fuses used in house wiring, the fusing factor will be around 1.9 to 2. Okay, 1.9 to 2, that will be the fusing factor. Understood? So that is regarding the fuse. And fusing element basically used is combination of lead plus tin. Okay, lead plus tin. Lead 63% and tin 37%. Okay, by varying the percentage of lead, we can vary the capacity or the fusing current of the fuse. So this is the generally used fusing element. Okay, lead plus tin alloy. So sometimes in exam you are supposed to ask, they will be asking you what is the best fuse material, okay, best fuse element, okay, I can say. So best fuse element is a silver. Okay, best fuse element is a silver. So there is one fuse called as HRC fuse, okay, high rupturing capacity fuse. In high rupturing capacity fuse, the fusing element used is silver. High rupturing capacity fuse is a very high capacity fuse basically, okay, as compared to a normal reversible fuse. So that is regarding the fuse. Next we will discuss about isolator. Okay, the circuit symbol of fuse is, this is what given here, the circuit symbol for isolator is like this. Okay, isolator is also called as no load switch. Okay, no load switch. Why is it no load switch? Means it is a switch which is operated only under no load condition. The condition is that there should be no current for operation. Okay, So this is one thing. And there is another rating of fuse. Okay, for fuse there is a rating. Okay, fuse rating is given as system voltage into fuse current, fusing current. This is called as rating of the fuse generally. Okay, simultaneously every switch will have a rating. Okay, rating of any switch for that matter. So I will give a generalized formula for rating of a switch. So rating of any switch is equal to the system voltage, normal system operating voltage, system voltage multiplied by switching current. Switching current is nothing but the current that is flowing through the switch at the time of switching, that can be making the switch or breaking the switch, making or breaking operation. So basically the capacity of a switch is in VA, volt amperes. Okay, it is apparent power. Okay, so simultaneously we are having a VA rating for a fuse also. Like that we should have VA rating for a isolator also, because isolator is also switch. We have to understand what is the rating of an isolator. So what is the rating of an isolator, isolator rating? So now rating of isolator or rating of any switch is nothing but the system voltage into the current at the time of switching. Now I told you isolator is a switch which is operated under no load. Under no load, what is the current? Current is zero. Now what is the rating of an isolator? 0 MVA or 0 volt amperes. So this is the isolator switch rating. Okay, so after isolator, so this is regarding isolator. So apart from isolator, we are having another switch, okay, which is called as popularly a circuit breaker, CB, circuit breaker. Circuit breaker is that switch which is a very special switch, or it is a, you know, it's a kind of a special constructed switch which can operate, that means making or breaking of the circuit can be possible under normal current conditions or faulty conditions. Faulty conditions means generally the value of currents will be high. As already discussed, circuit breakers are designed based on three-phase fault because they are the most worst possible faults. Understood? So that is how circuit breakers are designed, like, because they are ready to operate even under the most worst kind of faults. Okay, this is circuit breaker. So rating of a circuit breaker, again, when we talk about rating of a circuit breaker, okay, rating of CB is equal to nothing but the system voltage into circuit breaker current, isn't it? So circuit breaker current will be basically two types of circuit breaker current will be there. One is called as I breaking current. That means what is the value of current the circuit breaker is carrying at the time of breaking. So this is called rating of a circuit breaker, breaking capacity of a circuit breaker is, this is the formula. And there is another capacity of circuit breaker which is called as making capacity. So making capacity is nothing but 2.55 times of breaking capacity. Okay, so that is regarding the ratings of circuit breaker, right? So always whenever you are using a circuit breaker, it is a practice to use an isolator also along with a circuit breaker. Why? Because the purpose of using an isolator along with circuit breaker is for additional clearance, because inside a circuit breaker the contacts are enclosed inside the circuit breaker. You never knew whether the circuit is open or not, isn't it? Whereas isolator is open in the atmosphere. So you can easily see the isolator is open, then you can see additionally the circuit is completely open. So generally when the line field or line staff generally wants to operate or do some kind of repair in a transmission line, so they have to first switch off the line. That means they have to open the circuit breaker, and the circuit breaker is open, then they can switch off the, or I can say they can open the isolator in this way, like this. So after opening the isolator, what they have to do is, they have to, suppose this is the transmission line or some line is there, the operator wants to work on this section. So first initially the isolator is closed, circuit breaker is also closed. Now I have given the command from the remote operating, therefore circuit breaker is now open. After circuit breaker is open, still the isolator is closed. For additional clearance I wanted to know, so I will open the isolator also. Now I want to work on this line. To work on this line, see, already because the line is having current before the opening of circuit breaker, that all current is having magnetic energy, isn't it? Because the line has got inductance, and that inductance will have the magnetic energy. And suddenly if you have vanished the current, where will that inductive energy or that magnetic energy will go? It will charge the line capacitance, because between the line there will be capacitance, that capacitance will store the charge. Suppose if some line operator will come and touch the line at this point of time, that whatever the stored energy in the line capacitance is there, that will create an electric shock for him, which may be a fatal thing. So it is very much essential that Once you are, if you want to work on a transmission line, you have to open the circuit breaker and you have to open the isolator, and you have to initially first connect this part of the circuit breaker, this part of the line to the ground by using something called as earth rods or earth switch. So always it will be in this way. There will be an isolator, you will have a circuit breaker, and the other side of circuit breaker you will have a switch called as earth switch. Now when you close this switch, this part of the line will be connected to the earth. Whatever will be the stored charges will be discharged to the ground, and the line operator can come and work on the transmission line. So it is very much essential, if you want to work on a transmission line, in what fashion or in what sequence do you have to open the circuit breaker, isolator and the earth switch, means how you have to operate. So now see, first he is telling option, look at option A, first open CB. When you are opening CB, the current in the system became zero. If the current in the system became zero, you can open isolator. Yes, you can open the isolator. After opening the isolator, what we have to do, now you have isolated the part of the section of the transmission line. Now you have to close the earth switch. Once you close the earth switch, whatever the stored charge will be discharged. So okay, option A represents the correct sequence. Now you see, now he says that open the isolator. See, now you are directly opening the isolator means, okay, directly opening the isolator means already the circuit, say it is having some current. Now if you all of sudden with the full load current or whatever current is going, now if you open the isolator, that will create very huge sparks, and such sparks may come and hit the ground, and near the ground the field person who is opening the isolator will be there, and he will be suffering from that shock and he will melt then and there. So it is very dangerous and it is very fatal to open an isolator when it is loaded. So that is the reason why, because you see, the rating of a circuit breaker or isolator is 0 MVA. It cannot withstand anything. No part of current it can withstand. So definitely first, if you want to open the circuit breaker or if you want to switch off a line, first you have to open the circuit breaker, then open isolator. Okay. Simultaneously, when you want to make a circuit, okay, first you want to make a circuit means, first you have to close the isolator and then close the circuit breaker. Understood? What if you close the circuit breaker first? Now if you close the circuit breaker first, now this transmission line is connected to the load. As soon as you are trying to connect the isolator also, the sparking will again come into picture because the load is already connected. That is the reason why first you have to keep the circuit breaker open, first to close the isolator and then only close the circuit breaker. Okay, that is the sequence of operation. Next, reactance relay is normally preferred for the protection of against reactance relay earth fault. This was number of times. See, even in our last video we have discussed this particular question 2 or 3 times. This is again, so because this question is basically most times repeated in many PSC examination. Next question is, if a combination of HRC fuse and a circuit breaker is used, circuit breaker operates for us. So this question asked in 2014, and this question is basically found from CL Vadva power system book backside bits. Okay, so what is the, so you rarely find there is no answer for this question. So basically, as per the CL Vadva backside key, low overload currents is the answer, but you don't find explanation anywhere except this video. Okay, so what is the basically the explanation for this concept is, see, HRC fuse, okay, HRC fuse and circuit breaker, do a comparison. HRC fuse is basically a fast operating fuse as compared to circuit breaker. Okay, when you compare HRC fuse and circuit breaker is slow. Okay, circuit breaker is slow. Basically, circuit breaker, HRC fuse is used in such circuits, okay, which are very prominent circuits or very important circuits. Okay, which circuit is very important, in such circuits we will use HRC fuses. But means where the equipment is very costly or very sensitive equipment is there. But circuit breaker will be used in such circuits where relatively the equipment sensitivity is not much as we used for HRC fuses. Okay, and the currents which HRC fuses will interrupt will be comparatively less as compared to the circuit breaker currents, isn't it? So suppose let us say in a circuit we are using a HRC fuse. HRC fuse will operate for currents less than 100 amperes. Okay, and let us say circuit breakers are designed to operate for very very high values of current, let us say above 100 amperes. What if low overload currents will occur? Because see, overload current, any overload is a overcurrent only. Okay, low overload current means, let us say if 10 amperes is the rated value or rated current of this circuit. Now I am having different values of overloaded currents. Let us say 12 amperes is one overload current, 30 amperes is also overload current. See, any current above 10 amperes is overload current, but in this overload only you compare the magnitude. So here 12 amps is the low overload current, isn't it? It is a low overload current, and 30 amps is high overload current. Okay. Now this is, I am talking about a general small voltage circuit, but just talk about a big circuits. There the low overload currents may be usually less than 100 amperes, high overload current may be above 100 amperes. Suppose if you want to protect that particular transmission line, maybe the transmission line is connected to a very important or prominent equipment. Therefore, even if the overload current is low, you have to interrupt. But if you are using only a circuit breaker, it will wait until the current value, let us say rated current is some 50 amperes. Now if the current value is 60 or 70 also, circuit breaker won't respond until it reaches 100 amperes. So it will wait until 100 amperes. So until then the damage might have been taken place. Therefore, instead of setting the circuit breaker rating, so you might have challenged, sir, then why don't we set the circuit breaker for 60 amperes only if you want to interrupt that one? Because if you want to design a circuit breaker to interrupt low overload currents, then the relay rating will be, the cost of the relay will increase. Basically, circuit breakers are cheap as the cost, as the rupturing capacity or the current breaking capacity of the circuit breaker will be increasing. Basically, if you want to design a fast operating circuit breaker, and moreover, suppose even though you have designed a circuit breaker for 60 amperes, the time of operation is high as compared to a regular HRC fuse. So that is the reason why we are using a HRC fuse in combination with a circuit breaker. Because in the event of low overload currents, HRC fuse will come into picture and it will operate fastly and it will be disconnecting the circuit in a very cheap manner. Because to eliminate low overload currents, HRC fuse is the cheapest and fastest option available. So we have to use the both in series. So that is the expression for this kind of question. Lightning arrestor should be located. See, anybody who is going to protect you must be near you. So basically it should be near the transformer. That's it. Okay. Resistance switching is employed in. As I told you, resistance switching is, is for current chopping phenomena. Okay. What is current chopping phenomena? Current chopping phenomena is when you are trying to interrupt inductive current, whatever the magnetic field associated in the inductive current before the opening of circuit will be converted into electrostatic energy, that is half Li square converts into half Cv square, which will induce a prospective voltage of V is equal to I reactive, I is the reactive current, into L by C. This much amount of voltage, this is nothing but a restriking voltage will be introduced, and that voltage will try to restrike the arc. And so in order to eliminate that, we have to check, make sure that this half Li square does not convert into half Cv square. Before it is converted into half Cv square, between these both you have to place a resistor, because this resistor will dissipate all that energy into I square into R into T. So we will use resistance switching concept, and that value of resistance is equal to 1 by 2 into under root L by C. And basically this phenomena is prevalent in air based circuit breakers. So option D is the right answer. We have already seen that question in our last video also. Rate of rise of restriking voltage is dependent upon. So before that, we will discuss what is restriking voltage. So restriking voltage is that voltage, when I told you that half Li square is being converted into a half Cv square, isn't it, which will introduce a prospective voltage of V I L by C. This V is basically an instantaneous current, but what is the expression, original expression for this restriking voltage is, that is Vm, that is system peak voltage, multiplied by 1 minus cos omega n into t. Okay, this is called the restriking voltage ka formula. So this restriking voltage is having Vm. Vm is the peak voltage of the system voltage. Okay, L is system voltage ka peak voltage. And omega n is the natural frequency of oscillation, which is equal to 1 by under root L and C. Okay, multiplication of L and C. Okay, this is restriking voltage. Now I will ask you what is the maximum restriking voltage and when will it occur. So when do you get maximum restriking voltage? Look at the expression. When you will get omega n into t is equal to pi, okay, then you will get maximum restriking voltage, isn't it? So what will that magnitude, see, if you put cos omega n t is equal to pi, cos pi is minus 1, so minus 1 plus 1 will become 2 Vm. So restriking voltage max, so maximum restriking voltage will be 2 times the system peak voltage. So this is another important formula for us that may be asked in any competitive exam. Okay, now what is the time taken, what is the time taken for the system voltage to become maximum? From here, from this expression you can find out, no? So t peak, I am telling, means time taken for the restriking voltage to reach peak value is equal to pi by omega, isn't it? Pi by omega is the time taken for the system restriking voltage to reach rate of rise of restriking voltage, rate of rise of restriking voltage. Which is popularly called as triple RV. Okay, this is very, very important, many times asked. So rate of rise of restriking voltage means simply you can take the d by dt of V restriking voltage, isn't it? What is V restriking voltage? This is the V restriking voltage formula, isn't it? So if you take d by dt, differentiate with respect to time, what is that you're going to get? You will get omega into omega n into Vm, okay, into sine omega n into t. So this is called as rate of rise of restriking voltage formula. RRRV is equal to omega psi, okay, omega n into Vm into sin omega t, isn't it? RRRV max, okay, RRRV max. So the time, what is the RRRV max? Just put sin omega t is equal to 1, then the RRRV max will be omega n into Vm, that is the peak voltage. Or I can also write Vm by under root LC is the maximum value of rate of rise of restriking voltage. So this is one formula. So next, another thing that can be asked is, what is the rate of rise of restriking voltage, average rate of rise of restriking voltage? Average rate of rise of restriking voltage is nothing but, see, what is the maximum restriking voltage, maximum value of restriking voltage, and time taken to reach this maximum value. These things already we have seen. What is the maximum value of restriking voltage? Maximum restriking voltage is equal to how much? 2 times of Vm, isn't it? So 2 Vm is the maximum restriking voltage, divided by what is the time taken? What is the time taken to reach this peak value or maximum value? Pi by omega, isn't it? So pi by omega means it will get multiplied with omega, isn't it? So Vm into omega, what is Vm into omega? Rate of rise of restriking voltage maximum, isn't it? So 2 by pi into rate of rise of restriking voltage maximum is nothing but the average rate of rise of restriking voltage. Okay, so these are some important formulas regarding the restriking voltage concept. Okay, the rate of rise of restriking voltage is dependent upon what? It depends upon both inductance and capacitance of the system. Okay, so the same question has been repeated in 2015 also, 2014 and 2015 of ISRO, inductance and capacitance of the system. Next, symmetrical circuit breaker is, okay, so far we have been seeing about asymmetrical breaking capacity, now we will see about symmetrical breaking capacity. See, firstly, okay, breaking capacity we will write down, okay, breaking capacity. See, breaking capacity of a circuit breaker is nothing but root 3 times of system voltage into, because if it is a 3-phase system, into breaking current. Okay, breaking current is nothing but basically fault current. I break is nothing but IF only. Now this fault current or breaking current is actually two types. One is called as symmetrical fault current, and the other one is called as asymmetrical fault current. So one aspect is always asymmetrical fault current, okay, asymmetrical fault current is higher than symmetrical fault current, And asymmetrical fault current rating is used in British dominated or in Britain system, British system or Indian systems, okay? So, and symmetrical values are used in American systems. So basically almost all Indian breakers or Indian systems are based on British only. Therefore we will use asymmetrical braking capacity only, okay? Now if you are using asymmetrical braking current, then it will become asymmetrical braking capacity. If you are using symmetrical braking current, it will become symmetrical braking capacity. Understood? And always making capacity, okay, making capacity is equal to, okay, by some factor k times the braking capacity, okay, k times the braking capacity. That means, and okay, k value will be equal to 1.8 if it is symmetrical capacity, and k value will be 2.55 or 2.54 I can say if it is asymmetrical capacity. Okay, please keep these things in mind. So from this I can make out one conclusion that making capacity is greater than braking capacity, and in making capacity only asymmetrical making capacity is greater than symmetrical making capacity. Understood? In this way I can make different conclusions which may be utilized in competitive examinations. So symmetrical braking capacity of a circuit breaker is simultaneously braking capacity also, it is also it is less than symmetrical braking capacity. Okay, so symmetrical braking capacity is less than asymmetrical braking capacity. In this way also, for braking and making both we can write. Okay, why? Because asymmetrical currents are higher than symmetrical currents. By which material fuse element is generally made of? So it is silver. Silver is the best fuse material, therefore we will choose silver only. Next, dielectric strength of SF6 gas is 2 to 3 times more than air. It is a direct objective question. Negative sequence relay is used for protection of, this number of time repeated question, generators. General AC circuit breakers, AC distribution system, arc interruption in vacuum circuit breaker is designed to function time period of as less as possible, one cycle. In a biased differential relay, bias is defined as ratio of number of turns of restraining coil and